While the Skin Editor or Skin Tab in 3D Vista Virtual Tour Pro always allowed you to create skins with an immense level of customization and detail, it did admittedly take a little bit of getting used to the structure and mechanics of using the editor. So we have been and continue to be working on making the Skin Editor more intuitive and easier to use while preserving its range of customization and functions for you. The big first improvement in the Skin Editor in terms of logic and workflow is now out, and this is how it works. We are talking about the way in which you visualize and use all skin elements right here. Before, whenever we had projects with a few skin elements, buttons, individual stickers or boxes for each panorama, etc., and especially containers with sub-elements, this list could get quite long and cluttered. And you wouldn't immediately see which elements were the primary ones, which ones were sub-elements, etc. So many of you have actually been requesting we change the system to make it easier to work with, which is why this is what we started our big skin improvement project with. So this new skin element organization mode, which we call tree mode, is actually similar to how things work on other editing programs too, so it'll be very easy for you to understand. In this project, for example, where we have a number of elements, in the old system we would have an endless list of seemingly same level elements, whereas with this new tree mode we can immediately see all primary elements that make up our skin. Take this element here, which in turn contains a lot of other elements within it. Well, here it is summarized as the primary or top level element called left panel. And only as we go and open this element step by step, we can see the other elements well organized in hierarchies and below their respective mother element or container. So it's much easier to see the structure and hierarchy of our elements. This is the parent container, which contains these two children elements. This child element in turn contains all of these elements, and this sub-element again contains its own children elements, etc. Another advantage of this new tree system is that we can easily move elements around. All we have to do is click on the element and, without letting go, drag it to where in the hierarchy we want it. See, now it moved down in this list, so this is much easier now too. And thirdly, it is also easier to take an element out of one parent container and move it into another one without messing up the structure. Let's take this contact information, for example, and put it into this top right corner menu instead. So we drag it onto the settings container, and after a couple of seconds you'll see that it opens up and shows its content, okay? And we see how these open up when we stay on the parent for a moment, and then we just drop this in here. Perfect. It doesn't make much sense, but it's just so you see how that would work, how we can directly drag one element to transfer it from one parent to a completely different element. And finally, we also included a search function that allows you to search for elements, containers, buttons, and your skin. This is also a dynamic search, so as you type, you'll start seeing results that contain the typed letters. And then down here we see all the elements that contain the word we searched for, whether they're inside containers or children or parent of other containers, they all show up here. And then in case you want to edit one of the searched elements, simply double click on it, this one for example, and it immediately takes us to that element with its entire hierarchy here to see where it comes from, where it's located, and now we could go ahead and edit it like we're used to. And you can also double click on the element right here in order to change its name. Finally, it's worth noting that there are some elements that have a ghosted arrow, and if you click on it, it won't open like the other ones. This is because the ghosted arrow indicates that this is a container which could contain sub-elements, but does not do so at the moment. So it basically indicates that you can insert elements in here, that this is a container which is yet to be filled with elements. And that's it. We hope you like this new way of working with skin elements. Our in-house designers and project leaders that work with VT Pro on a daily basis did not stop thanking the coders for this change, so we think that it'll make your lives a whole lot easier as well. Thanks for watching.